If you've never grown gourds, you've never really lived. They're a lot of fun. Let me tell you about the hanging gourd gardens of Moss Mountain Farm. They start right here. You see this big long arbor? Well, it's perfect for growing a fast-growing vine. And when I talk about a fast-growing vine, gourds, you will not believe. I've got some seed down here and you'll see. I've kind of worked up this area. Gourds love lots of sun and they'll grow in just about any kind of soil. I've enriched this with some good potting soil. So there's lots of humus in here. And as soon as the soil begins to warm up, you see these irises? Well, they're just about finished, so that tells me it's time to plant the gourds. The chance of a frost has passed, and the soil is beginning to warm up, and gourds really like it hot. Now, what's amazing is they come in all different shapes. Last year, we had big, long dipper gourds, different shaped gourds hanging from here, and it worked out really well. And this year, I want to make sure that every inch of this is covered with leaves of gourd vines and all kinds of gourd blooms, as well as the gourds themselves. And we have another one of these arbors on the opposite side. I'm going to do the same thing for the same effect. Now, what you do is you just take the seeds, and they're really big, interesting seeds. You can see they're big, flat seed. Basically, what you're going to do is just cut, sort of space them about a foot apart, like this. I'm just going to push those in and cover them up. Now I've worked up the soil to about 12 inches deep, and I'm planting one variety here. This is the dipper gourd, the old-fashioned dipper gourd, the kind that they used to have by the well where they would dip out of a bucket some water and drink from it. Now what I'll do is once these come up, they'll have a primary set of leaves, and then the next set will be these big round leaves. These will germinate in about 10 days, and you'll see these great big leaves on them within 2 weeks, and then they start putting up runners, and that's when I'll lay some little sticks along here, and that'll give them a leg up, so to speak, so they can begin to climb over this entire arbor. Now, last year I actually took some string and kind of tied it along, and I may do that again this year. All you need is just something that kind of assists them. They put out little tendrils that will hang on to each of these metal supports that make the arbor. One last tip. I fertilize generously with an organic fertilizer because you really want to make sure they're well fed so you can grow the biggest gourds in the neighborhood. Hey, if you're enjoying following these tips on gardening, check in regularly. Make sure you subscribe to EI Home.